In this video, we are going to solve signal flow graph and we are going to find out overall gain or transfer function of the signal flow graph given. So, this is the signal flow graph given and we need to find out the overall transfer function of this signal flow graph. So, whenever they are asked to find out the transfer function of signal flow graph, then we need to move to Marson's gain formula. Marson's gain formula is equivalent to overall gain or transfer function is equivalent to T of S is equivalent to 1 by delta summation k is equivalent to 1 to n and pk delta k. We know the values of delta, pk and delta k from the previous video. So, in previous video we discussed about this Marson's gain formula. So, where delta is equivalent to 1 minus sum of all individual loop gains plus, so 2 non-touching loop gains plus 3 non-touching loop gains plus so on. And coming to pk, so this is nothing but forward path gains. And coming to delta, so where delta is, delta k is nothing but delta without touching that kth forward path, the path of the graph, the path of the loop which is not touching kth forward path is called as this delta k. So, I will show you one by one. First, I want to discuss about pk, that means forward paths. So, in our signal flow graph given, we are having two forward paths. You can see here. So, this is primary forward path which is indicated by arrows. Forward path means the path between input to output. How many paths are there in between input to output, those are called as forward paths. So, here you can see from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 6, 7, 8. This is one path and another one is 1 to 2, 2 to 5 directly like this and 6, 7, 8. These two are the two forward paths in this signal flow graph. I am going to draw the two graphs here. So, here I am going to design my forward paths. So, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8. So, this is R of S and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the gain here is 1, G5, G4 and G3, G2, G1 and here 1. So, this is G2, G1. And here C of S. So, now here I am going to consider my forward path gain as P1. Why? Because here my forward path gains are considered in terms of PK. So, that is why I am starting with 1. How many forward paths are there? That many suffixes will be there for P. So, I am considering this like P1. P1 is equivalent to forward path gain is equivalent to multiplication of all gains in that path. So, here this is equivalent to G1, G2, G3, G4, G5. So, G1, G2, G3, G4, G5 will be your forward path gain, first forward path gain. Again, you are having another forward path, that means another path to input to output. So, here that path also I am going to consider here. So, from 2 to 5 directly and 6 and 7 and 8. So, this is also another forward path from input to output, first node to 8th node and the second to 5 I am having directly. So, here you can see you need to mention all the gains G6 and here 1 and here after 5 to 6 you are having G4, G5 and here you are having 1. Now, here this forward path gain I am going to consider like P2. P2 is equivalent to, so P2 is nothing but multiplication of this forward path gain. This forward path gain is also multiplication of all gains in this path. So, you need to multiply all gains. So, gain always indicated on the branch. So, here 1 into G6 into G4 into G5 into 1. This will be gain of this path 2. P2 represent forward path 2. So, here this path gain is equivalent to G6, G4 and G5. So this will be second forward path gain. So we derived two paths, we are having two paths. So total number of forward paths is equivalent to 2. So that two paths we got the gains. Now this is the time to derive the value of delta. So we know that delta is equivalent to 1 minus sum of individual loops, plus sum of two non-touching loops, plus sum of three non-touching loops from sum of four non-touching loops, like that. So now first of all we will see the individual loops, how many individual loops are there. If you observe here, so here I am having one loop, so this is one loop, and here I am having another loop like this. So here I am having one loop, here I am having another loop. So only two loops are there. So that two loops I am going to consider here. So that two loops I am going to consider here like this. Loops, how many loops are there means I am going to consider P11 loop, or I am going to consider first loop. My first loop is equivalent to like this. So 3 to 4 I am having loop. So minus H1. So this is G2 and this is 3 and this is 4. This one loop. But here you can see this is not loop. You can see the direction of this arrow. This coming to this point. So this is not loop. Only this point is loop. This is not going to be a loop. So now this path gain I am considering like P11. So this loop gain is nothing but multiplication of gains here. So G2 minus G2H1 will be this loop gain, individual loop gain. Coming to another individual loop, so here you are having another individual loop. From 6 to 7 you are having a loop. So from 6 to 7 I am having another loop. So that loop gains are G5 and in feedback minus H3. Now the gain of this loop is equivalent to multiplication of, so here I'm going to consider 1 2 P12 like this. So as I consider one loop, first loop as P11, and here I consider P12, and here this is equivalent to minus G5 H3. Is there any other individual groups or loops? Is there means there is no other individual groups, individual loops are not there. So only two individual loops are there. That individual loops I consider as my individual loops. For example, if you are having loop like this, if you are having another loop like this, that means, so you are having loop like this, mentioning like they are having some here minus H1, H2. For example, if you are having minus H2 like this, in your given problem, if you are having another loop like this, so you can take that loop also. So that means now for this problem, there is no change in forward paths. You can see I just added a loop, that's it. But I didn't change the number of forward paths. Number of forward paths will be like this only. But coming to the individual loops, so here is a individual loop. So this is a individual loop, and again this is a individual loop, top side. So just to show you, the individual loops are may have common nodes, I considered that node. So that is like this. So 3, 4 and 5, top side it's having minus H2, and here G2, and here G3. Coming to the gain of that individual loop, So you are having P13 is equivalent to minus G2 G3 H2. Minus G2 G3 H2 will be your gain of that individual loop. I will write here. So I am redrawing that. So 3, 4, 5. And I am having minus H2. I am having minus H2 here. 3, 4, 5. And here I am having G2. And here I am having G3. So now the gain I am indicating like P13. Third individual loop gain. So multiplication of all that gains. G2, G3, H2. Minus G2, G3, H2. So sum of all individual loops we can have now, but we are having sum of 2 non-touching loop sum and 3 non-touching loop sum. We need to get that. Is there any 2 non-touching loops are there? Totally we are having 3 loops. How many number of loops are there means 3 loops. In this 3 loops, if these 3 loops are non-touching, then we may have 3 non-touching loops. But this loop and this loop are touching. That means first loop and third loop are touching. So definitely there won't be 3 non-touching loops. So is there any 2 non-touching loops? Yes, there are 2 non-touching loops, 2 sets of 2 non-touching loops. That means 1 and 2 are non-touching. So that will comes under pair of non-touching loops. And third and second are also non-touching. So those are another pair of non-touching loops. So 2 non-touching loops. 2 non-touching loops are. So here I am taking the 2 non-touching loops. First one and second one are non-touching. So 3 to 4. 3 to 4. I am having G2 here and minus H1 here. And 6 to 7. Minus H3 and G5. So these 2 loops are non-touching. How we can get the gain of these 2 non-touching loops pair means we need to multiply all the gains in these 2 loops, then you are going to get. So here we are going to get P21. I mentioned with P21. P21 is equivalent to G2, G5. H1, H3. Here this is 2 non-touching loops. 2 non-touching loops gain will be multiplication of gains in the 2 loops. So again, this loop and this loop are also non-touching. That means this loop and this loop are not touching. That means there is no common node for the loops. So here I am going to consider these 2 loops also. So 3 to 4, 4 to 5. And I am having minus H2 here, G2 and G3, 3, 4, 5. And another loop is 6 to 7, I am having G5. 6 to 7, I am having G5. Then P22 is equivalent to, I am representing with P22, you can represent like anything. So, multiplication of all that gains. That means, so here minus. Minus, so here I am having minus H3, minus into minus plus, so G2, G3, G5, H2, H3, G2, G3, G5, H2, H3 will be these 2 non-touchings gain. Now I can substitute each and everything in this, then I am going to get my delta value. If I substituted in delta, sum of individual loops, so P11, plus P12 plus P13. These all are individual loops. So minus of minus everything I am going to give plus. So G2H1 plus G5H3 plus G2 G3 H2. This is about individual loops. Sum of 2 non-touching loops. So sum of 2 non-touching loops means these 2 addition. So that means plus g2 g5 h1 h3 plus g2 g3 g5 h2 h3 g2 g5 g3 h2 h3. So this is about delta. If you got delta k, then you can complete the Marson's gain formula. How will get delta k? So delta k means delta 1 first. K is equal to, as we are having p1 and p2, so you will have delta 1 and delta 2. Delta 1 is nothing but delta when the gain of loop which is not touching first forward path. So 1 minus, so here 1 minus the gain of loop which is not touching first forward path. Is there any loop which is not touching this first forward path? All the loops are touching first forward path. So there is no loops which is having gain which are not touching first forward path. There is no loops are there without touching that first forward path. That's why I considered 0. So you are going to get 1 here. Delta 2, 1 minus the loop gain which is not touching the second forward path. Is there any loop which is not touching second forward path? Yes, definitely is there. So whatever this first loop is there, that is not touching our second forward path. You can see. So this loop is in between 3 to 4 only. Here 3 to 4 we are not having this second forward path. Definitely we can take that loop gain to calculate delta 2. If you consider this third path is touching at 5. Only the individual first individual loop is not touching the second forward path. So we can take that as not touching loop for second forward path. That path gain is minus h1 g2. So this is equivalent to 1 plus h1 g2. So if you substitute everything in this, so in this formula, then you are going to get the actual transfer function. So 1 by delta means, so here 1 by delta means delta value is that. So I am going to substitute that delta value. Pk delta k means, so p1 delta 1 plus p2 delta 2. p1 means this, delta 1 means 1. So p1 means g1, g2, g3, g4, g5. p1 delta 1 means 1 plus p2 delta 2. p2 means g6, g4, g5 into 1 plus g2 h1. So g6, g4, g5 into 1 plus g2 h1 divided by, so delta you can take, so that delta value is equivalent to 1 plus g2 h1 plus g5 h3 plus g2 g3 h2 plus g2 g5 h1 h3 plus g2 g3 g5 H2, H3. So this will be your transfer function of the signal flow graph. Like this way we need to derive the transfer function of the signal flow graph given. First we need to ensure the forward paths, after that individual loops, after that 2 non-touching loops, after that 3 non-touching loops, 4 non-touching loops if possible. Maximum in problems only 2 non-touching loops they will give. And maximum they will give 3 non-touching loops. Definitely they won't give any 4 non-touching loops like that. So in this problem they given only 2 non-touching loops. So after considering individual and non-touching loops, you need to calculate delta. After calculating delta, we need to calculate delta k. That means according to the number of paths, you will get delta k values. Here you are having 2 forward paths. That's why delta values also you will get 2. Delta 1 and delta 2. Delta 1 is nothing but delta value only, but 1 minus the path gain or loop gain which is not touching first forward path. 1 minus loop gain which is not touching second forward path. whatever the loop which is not touching that kth forward path is there, that you need to subtract from 1, and after getting delta 1, delta 2, p 1, p 2 and this delta, you need to substitute in Marson's gain formula to calculate transfer function of the signal flow graph.